The turbulence feature was introduced in Particle Illusion 2021, enabling you to create more organic particle simulations. So in this tutorial, I'm going to introduce you to all of the new turbulence settings so that you can start using it in your own work. Okay, so to help visualize the turbulence settings, we're going to start with this plane emitter. You can see shape is set to plane, and I've brought velocity right down to zero. If we just play this back, see the particles aren't moving at all. Now in the emitter controls, you can see there's position turbulence and size turbulence. Now we'll look at position turbulence first. So this is set to zero. I'm going to change this to 100. And that changes the position of the particles on the stage and gives it kind of a fractal noise-like look. If I press play, then nothing happens. They're still stationary. But if we come up to turbulence field and down to auto evolve speed, let's change this to 100. Now the particles start to move with a nice natural organic undulation. Other settings under turbulence field include frequency, and frequency adjusts the size of the noise pattern. So a smaller number gives us a larger pattern. And a larger number gives us a smaller pattern. Bring this back to 100. And octaves and octave frequency scale and amplitude scale all relate to the number of the noise patterns. And these can be increased or decreased to add more or less detail. So if I say bring octaves all the way up to 8, which is the maximum, with octave frequency scale and amplitude scale at 100, you don't see any change. But if we start bringing up the frequency scale, and see how we get a lot more detail. And bring up the amplitude scale. If you go too far, then you'll start to get this buzzing effect. Let's bring this back down to 2 and 100 and 100. Personally, I don't use the octave settings too much. I tend to use frequency more. Let's go ahead now and increase the size turbulence. So now you can see the size of the particle is also affected by the turbulence field settings. If we select the particle node, you'll notice that particles have their own turbulence field controls. And these will make more sense if we duplicate the particle. So I've got the particle selected. If I come up to the hamburger menu and choose duplicate particle type, and change the particle shape. I'm going to choose this one here. That's very difficult to see because it's right on top of the other particle. First of all, let's look at offset. If I increase this by, say, 2, now you can see we're just getting a slight offset. And this can be quite interesting at these low settings. So it's moving in exactly the same way as the other particle, but it's just slightly offset. Make this 10. And we'll just bring up the size of that particle too. And there we go. You bring that back to 0, now you can see it's sitting right on top of the other particle again, which is also quite an interesting look when you use this ring over this dot particle. They almost look like frog eggs. If you wanted to add more random offset, you can increase the random offset value. This adds a little bit of randomization in there. I'll just reset both of these to 0. And frequency scale can be used to scale the emitter frequency settings. If we drop this value here, say to 0.1, this reduces the detail in the duplicate's turbulence field. Have a look at this. Now these rings look like they're just very large waves. Let's just bring up the size a little bit more. You can get some quite interesting effects by having the main turbulence settings set by the emitter and then duplicating the particle type and then just changing these turbulence field settings just slightly. So the particles are being moved by the same turbulent forces but at different frequencies, creating these kind of interesting multi-layer looks. And we might want to change the color of that particle as well. Okay, I'll just change this back to 1. And that puts them right on top of each other again. Particles also have their own position turbulence and size turbulence options. If I change the position turbulence for this particle, that also gives us this kind of offset. And the same for size. So having both turbulence field and individual position and size turbulence gives you plenty of options to fine-tune the look of each individual particle. Turbulence can also be introduced over the life of the particle, and I'm using an example here where I've just set a couple of position keyframes to keyframe the emitter from left to right across the stage. And you can see that this is a pretty vanilla look. There's no real movement to the particles. There's a touch of velocity, but basically it's pretty plain. And we can add a lot more interest to this by animating the position turbulence over life. And if I come all the way down to the bottom, it's the bottom two, position turbulence over life and size turbulence over life. I'm not going to set keyframes for size, I'm just going to do position. And I'll set the first keyframe by clicking and choosing linear. Then just move the particle time indicator down a bit. And I'm going to bring this up. My graph is set to auto zoom, which is really handy. Now I don't want there to be any turbulence at zero. Want that to be introduced a little bit after the particle's been born. And I will just bring this one here, like that. So now if we click play, you'll see there's no turbulence in this area here. That corresponds to this part of the particle's life. And then turbulence is introduced from this point to this point over the particle's life. You can probably make that a little more extreme. Just drag this up a little higher. And there we go. Now we can really see it. If you want to add a little bit of variation to the particle's movement, there's also position turbulence variation. I've already got that 165. Let me just make that 0. So I was playing around with that before and I'd increase that. But at 0, you can see the particles really are kind of sticking to that path. So if we bring that variation up again, we can make it look even more natural and dynamic. So definitely think about how you can add more interest to your particle simulations by animating these over-life parameters, both position and size. Now with super emitters, you've got 3 levels of control over the turbulence. You've got the emitter controls, these ones here, position turbulence and size turbulence. You've got the free emitter controls, which is this one here, F position turbulence, and also position and size turbulence, which scale the amount of turbulence for the particle. And of course, you've got the particle's turbulence, position and size. So currently, this doesn't have any turbulence. If we click on the free emitter and just bump up the position turbulence, now you can see we're getting turbulent particles, like that. But check this out, we can also increase the position turbulence for the free emitter. And let's bring the position turbulence right down to 0. And the reason I wasn't getting any result for the free emitter is because the emitter's position turbulence is set to 0. Make this 100, that's going to be way too much. We make this 10. And now the free emitter has turbulence. So it can get a little bit confusing, these different levels. Just remember that the position turbulence for the emitter scales both the free emitter and the particle, and the position turbulence settings for the free emitter scales the particle. We come back to the free emitter and now increase the position turbulence. Make that 1000. So now we've got particle turbulence and free emitter turbulence. And one other thing to notice is that free emitters don't have an F size turbulence option because size turbulence is specifically related to particles. Okay, so that's everything you need to know to get started with turbulence. Why not spend a bit of time now checking out the many presets that use turbulence? Then join me in the next lesson where we'll look at the new lines feature and how you can use it with turbulence. Also, you can download PI Standalone for free, including thousands of free particle emitter presets at borisfx.com, where you can also learn more about the plugin version of Particle Illusion with extra features, including built-in Mocha motion tracking, After Effects light and 3D layer tracking, and emitters on text and masks.